Episode commencing in 3, 2, 1. Episode initiated.
Buckle up your gauntlet and slot your Infinity Aeon Stones into place. It's time for another reality-bending episode of The Critvengers, The Cosmic War. It is I, Patrick the GM, the Gamora-murdering sicko titan, ready to do what it takes to win this fight. Joining me in splitting the party and failing to go for the head are my five teammates and soon-to-be dusted friends and players. Across the digital table from me, don't get him sober. You wouldn't like him when he's sober. It's Miles playing the incredible Raymond.
Good evening.
On my right, he's missing his hammer, so he has to reforge a wicked new blade in the heart of a dead star. It's Tyler playing the mighty Edroxanol.
Everything will seems to work out.
To his left, she's ready to throw herself off a cliff to save a dude with bow and arrows. It's Rebecca playing the Alinron's widow.
Hello.
To my left, he's grown a sweet beard over his cheek pouches, so you know he means business. It's you playing Captain Nacular.
Excelsior.
And finally, to his left, he's got a plan that involves just straight up ripping the glove off of a dude. It's Gerberta's Iron Not Found.
It's me.
Like Aeron Not Found, but Iron Man.
Get it?
Guys, I got good news and bad news for you. I don't know what you need to hear first.
Oh, good.
I mean, let's start with the bad news.
All right. Well, they're both the same news. There is no last time on trivia this week because we've just gone out of a knockdown, drag-out fight with your hated Kishali. So yeah, no recap, as it was just six rounds of a very deadly combat. The only question I can think of is, how many crits were there? And there were five.
There were too many.
It was a high crit episode.
How much damage did Raymond do?
So much.
I don't even remember.
I could tell you that at the end, the commander had 158 HP. And Tyler critted her for 160.
that was pretty early on in the fight, but yes. Yeah, so I couldn't think of any questions. Let's just get right back into the drama of this Civ simulation that your characters find themselves in. Indeed,
we're in Civ City.
Right out of combat when we last left off. And you all are still alive, still doing well. You've taken out this base of Civ soldiers, and this seems to be like a command hub of a sorts. There's lots of computers in this room and the next, which I'll reveal for you guys. What would you like to do?
Smash all the computers.
I mean, that's what I was going to say, but then it was like, somebody probably ought to look at them or something. Yeah, I don't know. It's not going to be me.
There's probably some data we can get off of those things.
Ah, man, data is always in between me and the computer smashing that I love to do.
Oh, it's better than lore.
Don't you dare say that.
Yeah, and it seems like, I believe some of you might know Kishaleen. The head computer here is a state-of-the-art battlefield system, and it does seem to be routed to a large communications network here in the base, maybe coordinating satellites and battlefield conditions from all over the planet. So this is definitely a major hub for their war effort against your guys' Civ Empire. Why don't you make me a computer check, see if you can log into this main mainframe.
Gilar will assist.
All right, let's try to check roll into the mainframe. I'll roll. It's a 45.
We don't need any assisting here, Drew.
That's why I announce it just in case.
Afterwards, it's a tier 7 computer, and that is enough to obtain deeper access and bypass the rank 5 shock grid countermeasure.
May as well be a light bright.
It's always got to be a shock grid. It's always got to be a shock grid.
But yeah, as you guys, you know, can see Raymond hacking into it, why don't you all either make me a computer check or a perception check as you're maybe peering over his shoulder, his tentacle, or what have
you. Do I need to make another check or?
Yeah, go. Well, what's your bonus? Plus 35?
Let me double
check if you have to make a check. Yeah, make me another check.
Okay.
I am the goat. Bow before my rolls.
You literally rolled a zero. I need everyone to know that Tyler literally rolled a zero.
Straight up. Oh, and we got a natural one from Nacular. Oh, no good. No good.
That's still a 43.
You want to give one or the other a try, Jabert?
Yeah, let's see here. We're talking computers or what was the other one you said?
Perception.
Perception. Let's see, my computers is... Oh, look at that. I got the same thing in both. I'll go perception. Mix it up. Oh, 32.
Not great, but I think the only one...
No, it's not a zero, so I'm counting that as a win.
I'm happy. The only... I think person that can really tell exactly what's happening on the screen is it seems to be the same page or subsystem kind of cycling over and over again here. It at first it seems like maybe garbled information or some kind of unique countermeasure, but you guys can't really get a way around it. I think Raymond, you understand that whoever's memory banks these are taken from, they never hacked into this computer, so they don't have the information to fill the simulation with what was actually in these computers. So you've come up against a holographic wall, if you will, in this memory here. And because of that, you have gained a lucidity point.
I'm never making it out of the simulation.
There's a lot of perception checks. I'm so sorry, Tyler.
Gaining a lucidity point means what again?
Yes. So, and let's see.
Going, and did I gain that?
You did. I think you're the only one that did, unfortunately.
Oh.
Yeah, we'll fast forward here as you get to the final room of the fortress and can kind of crack your way through the rest of this base and out into the front doors here, where you are greeted with the sounds of Civ hovercraft descending upon this fortress. The cavalry is here, if you will. A huge group of heavily armored Civ commandos come to your rescue, start administering aid, and you see another like battalion marching a group of captured Kishali up from the surrounding countryside, their weapons disabled, their armor stripped from them. You guys are loaded onto a military transport.
Oh, yeah, you overhear a Civ officer saying, none of these will be imprisoned any longer. These soldiers that you saw what they did to our men. We will kill 9 out of every 10 and let the one survivor escape to spread fear amongst their ranks.
The door of your hovercraft closes up and you hear degenerator fire as it lifts off and takes you off planet once more, perhaps surviving another battlefield, getting the accolades afterwards here. And in the hovercraft, a very familiar menu pops up, the root menu, if you will, of this simulation. And you've got a few that you've seen on here before: a socially appropriate party, medical miracles, exemplary education, and exit, which I think you've seen all those before. But there's a additional choice that you've not seen here that reads Degenerator Rally. Simulation 6. What would you guys like to pick here?
Exit.
Beep, beep, beep. It glitches out and says insufficient conditioning for exit. Beep.
One of these days.
So we haven't done medical miracles, right?
We have. I thought we did.
We have?
You have not.
Oh,
no, we haven't done that one. And we also haven't done the new one. But I think everything else we've done.
Yeah, I think we decided that we needed to do the battle before the medical miracles in case we needed to heal after that.
Mm.
Right.
But now there's Degenerator Rally, which sounds
kind of like
that. Sounds like monster trucks, but like Stellar Degenerator themed or something.
Yeah, let's do that one.
Seems cool.
Right. I want to drive stuff.
I mean, I don't know that that's what it is.
I know, but I'm just having fond flashbacks of being a Raxalite and just letting loose with a vehicle.
Let me just rewrite the entire AP real quick for Miles.
Please do. Please do. That is your job. You have to like bend to my whims.
I've already written an AP volume. Yeah, so as you click on Degenerator Rally, indeed, the whole world here goes dark once more. Do you guys, would you care to burn an RP? Does anyone need to, I forget if we did it at the...
I think we did at the end of the last episode.
Yeah, we did, but I would, I don't want to use a potion, never mind.
Well, yeah, that's the other thing. If you wanted to heal up HP, I think I kind of rushed you through that. Right, so as you come back into this new simulation, you see yourself in a very pristine looking state-of-the-art research facility, and looking around you, it seems like a place that you've been before. You have kind of like a deja vu here, and thanks to the advanced quantum communications developed through rel state technologies in the Civ Dominion, you've gathered all of your underlings, everyone working for you in the research facility, to watch a rally live broadcast across the universe. And the footage shows massive crowds of jubilant civs across the planet Davarex watching these monumental size holographic screens hovering over the titanic buildings of the city. And each of them, there's a news feed of interspersed, you know, shots, multiple camera angles of a massive conical starship, a dozen miles long, being escorted by a few of the largest civ ships in the fleet that look kind of dwarfed in comparison. They look like little stepping stones next to this massive vessel. It is constructed from spirals of stone atop a metal core, and it contains a dish-like device that kind of crackles with destructive energy, and a familiar voice calls out over this broadcast that says, "Behold the instrument of Civ dominance over not only the Kishali, but every other feeble species within this galaxy. May I present to you all the Stellar Degenerator."
Boo.
I mean,
no. I've seen this episode before.
Your monitor fills up with...
I look at it and I say, "I'm going to fly a ship into that one day."
I'm going to burn that up. That seems so familiar. The crowds are just erupting in cheers, and there's wailing and tears of happiness.
Are you saying there's whalers on the moon?
There's wailing keeners ready for the pending victory against the Kish that's taken so many brave civs here. While you guys are looking around here watching this feed, why don't you make me a perception check? Something seems familiar about this stellar degenerator, they said. That seems...
Is it a perception?
Yes.
Another zero.
That's amazing.
Tyler,
two natural ones in a row.
Tyler's Tyler's getting him out of his system. It's like,
Droxenol was just like, I think I left my keys there.
Right. So we've got, once again, only a single success amongst the group here, and that's Nacular. The stellar degenerator does look familiar, but also as you're taking a look around this facility, it's got curved walls. You see a bay of scientific tables and different experiments going on, and you kind of blink looking at them, maybe close your eyes for a moment, and then when you open them, you see them looking a little worse for wear, dark light, and some strange looking creatures kind of exploring these tables here. What looks like a lizard man.
Is one of them furry?
Oh, you look at your hands there, Furry. Ah! Yeah, this looks exactly like a place that rings in your mind as a research facility on Generat. But as you blink, you know, it looks sparkling, brand new, brightly lit, and full of your Civ compatriots. Looking back at the feed, there's, you know, it's going to be a long broadcast. There's speeches by government officials, scientists, and as the rally begins to wind to a close, there's suddenly like shouts and cries from the gathered crowd as the feed shows dozens of strange looking starships kind of decloaking right next to the stellar degenerator, still tiny in comparison to the super weapon, but the announcer seems flabbergasted. He's like, oh folks, this is just another desperate attack by the agents of the Kishali. We will drive them back with the might of the Civ military. But no sooner as he gets out this explanation, indeed, it seems like the space around the stellar degenerator begins to bend and fold as the edges of it kind of curve in on itself. And in the blink of an eye, it kind of disappears along with all the Kishali ships. No debris left behind, no other enemies in the space, just a giant empty void between the Civ vessels. And the announcer stammers, oh my goodness, well please everyone be quiet, this is a trick, they couldn't have taken it. Indeed, a chill runs down your spines, plural. The Kishali, if they have taken the main weapon that the entire Dominion has been pouring resources into for years, the Kishali will be unstoppable. What you feared the most has occurred. One of your coworkers looks up to you and says, What are we going to do? If they have the weapon, we're powerless. Please lead us, Varanch. And a voice calls out that says, we do what we must do, what we have prepared for this day. We must make a way and get ready to launch Arc Prime immediately. As you're looking around, looking for this voice of Varanch, you realize that it is coming from your own Civ bodies. You get a glimpse of yourself in one of the reflections on a computer screen here as you see a very stern-looking Civ, scars along their face, and the engineers around you kind of scrambling to get to work in preparations, maybe pushing their bantered slaves forward to get work done. This scene kind of fades out here, and once more, the root menu opens up to you, and now there's only two options. One is restart simulations, and the other reads exit.
Can we exit now?
Well, we didn't do the medical miracle, so we got to restart so we can get restart. To that. Yep. Right?
I gotta guys, we're going for the platinum here.
Yeah,
I was about to say, if you don't do it, then you definitely are getting a 99% completion. No, I will have to make you do all of the simulations again if you pick
exit's good.
Restart.
Exit's fine.
We're going back to laugh. In fact, pretend they hit restart simulations and go back 4 episodes, everyone listening. And then come right back here. But they did everything the exact same. It's so weird. No, are you guys ready to hit exit?
So ready.
Slam the button.
Quite frankly, expected something bigger.
That's what she said.
Right. So slowly the digital VR world kind of around you begins to fade away from real state. It's fingerprints on your mind just kind of disintegrating. I will remind you, and you guys can maybe text in the chat to Rebecca. You have the ability... Alinron's has the ability to take 10 bulk of items from the simulation and bring it back out with you. So do that in the chat. And as you open your eyes next, the light hitting you is blinding. It's like right in your face, LEDs in a small but very, very luminous chamber. You feel covered in what certainly isn't, but feels like cold chicken grease. You guys know about cold chicken grease?
Oh, jeez.
Why are you talking about schmaltz? You talking about schmaltz?
It's schmaltzy in here. Mm. There are wires and needles poking into your arms and neck. And indeed, you're in your undergarments in a small capsule. Your weapons, your armor.
Patrick, I don't wear undergarments. So.
But yeah, I was not lying. The wires are spliced into your arms. All two of them. I think everyone only has two arms. And you are back into a body that feels real, but still, it's been a while since you've been in it. You are missing your weapons, your armor, Alindra. Your legs are detached and nowhere to be seen. Though, if you guys had augmentations installed, they are still attached to you. And as you kind of like fumble your way forward, the tops of these coffin-like capsules you're in spring open. I've moved us to a new map here. And there's still sensations in your mind of you've got like four missing Civ tentacles that you can like feel for a second. Like you try to push yourself up with these phantom limbs and you just kind of like fall forward a little bit. As you're not used to just using only a couple of arms here to steady you. The room around you, it's brightly lit and in blue lights. Everything is a bright blue as you get out of the capsule. What do you guys say upon exiting the simulation that's been what feels like your life for months and months?
I think Raimi just throws up.
It's a good time to do it.
Again?
How many simulations have you exited? I think Alindra would wake up and scream that she's missing her legs, like all six of them.
Oh gosh, all six of them are gone. I think maybe your if that counts as, does your speed adjustment count as an augmentation?
Yeah, I think she has a full replacement.
Speed suspension.
Yeah. So the suspension like works onto your grafted legs, and those were detached, but you're just kind of like strapped in there, like a.
Oh, okay. I still have my leg. Well, I don't know. My original leg got cut off that one time by
both legs got cut off.
Will not be named.
Cut off, yeah.
Did they both get cut off at some point?
It's been an eventful season. I can understand you forgetting losing both your legs. Yeah, as you look around here. Besides missing all that good stuff, I mean, you feel kind of malnourished, maybe a little hungry, and taking a peek, not a lot that you can tell, but you look over at a...
Peeking is probably what I would do. After waking up out of the Matrix, I would do some peeking, some stern peeking about.
Well, you're looking mostly at your own hands, but as you look over to your allies, you can tell that Raimi has like a good amount of facial hair, maybe a week or so's worth more than when you saw him last. And all of you look pretty darn tired as you're getting your bearings here.
Andross is going to walk over to Alindra and just, I don't know, honorably hold you up. I don't know. Get you moving.
Piggyback ride.
I was going to say, you're going to put her on your back like she'd see 3PO in Cloud City.
She's facing the other direction.
Yeah, I think, maybe Andross just says, I know this isn't ideal, but we'll find you something to get you moving. So just bear with this for a little while.
Aren't my suspensions like right there, or no, they're missing completely?
They're attached to your legs. So.
Oh, okay. No. They're just not working. I'm confused.
You don't have legs right now, is what he's saying.
You guys don't have attached to anything. Right? Any item that you had on your person. It seems like we just did this with the Kish, but it's happening.
It was a room that looked exactly like this one, so I'm suspicious that there's a trap right here.
Oh, don't go there.
There's a room full of people right over here. I can take care of that.
I'm going to go out to the left. And
no, you don't have your sword to deflect the blast.
No, he doesn't need his sword because he's carrying Alindra, who has a solar weapon, so all he has to do is stand with his back to the bad guys.
Oh, this is a good idea.
Well, it's not.
Why swing weapon when can swing organism who has weapon?
Now that you mention the bad guys, of course, a huge crashing sensation of blaring klaxons and green and purple warning lights begin to flash across this room. Little scrolling holographic letters in Civ you can read across the glass lids of these coffin-like chambers. Read the words indoctrination failure and liquidation units arriving shortly.
Uh-oh. I unhook Raimi and set him down on the ground and say, nice beard. And
he can do it. He's got his legs.
Well, I know.
Do you strap him to your back for fun?
I can just for giggles. I put him on my back too. Oh wait, no, my strength is 13. I don't do that. I don't. Someone has to carry me.
I'm sure you guys are over it, but give me a perception check as you're
can
looking
I do
around
it?
This room.
Can I do it? I want this
for
so
three.
Bad. The trifecta.
Three for three.
Trifecta.
Did you do that?
I'm the goat.
Tyler is banking so much.
He's the woat.
Good energy here,
dude.
I don't understand how that happened.
We've never been so excited about three natural ones in a row.
It's true.
That's unbelievable. I dare you to find someone else who's done that. I dare you.
I found someone else who's done that. You on a previous episode, I'm sure.
Bad news here. You don't see your gear anywhere in this room. And with a cursory glance, what would you guys like to do?
I mean, not for nothing, but I mean, if we've been in here for a week, I'm sure Raimi being human has to take a comically large pee-pee.
Yeah, just do that.
They've got catheters hooked up to you. You're fine.
Yeah, no, you had to pull that out before.
Oh,
here for a while,
Patrick.
You got a diaper on as well. And
you're not Austin Powers coming out of the freezing tube.
Edros would try to summon a weapon from one of the tattoo. He has a tattoo fusion weapon.
Yeah,
does that happen?
It does if that counts as an augmentation. Yes. Magical augmentation, yes.
That would count as a type of fusion, I think. No. Yes. Yes, so.
It
can be noticed.
It's a, yeah, if it's a part of a weapon, like a fusion, then that was detected.
Okay. Then I would
taken
not
away. Okay. Yeah. Would you guys like to do some more searching here? There's a couple different corners of the room with some small desks. What looks like computers and things like that.
Yeah, I'm looking really for is sorry, not guys, in. But I am missing my legs. Can we, like, do a more thorough search to try
Alindra,
to find my
settle products? Down. We know that you have restless leg syndrome. We'll find them. It's okay.
Okay.
All right, y'all. I'm going to go into the southeast corner and start rifling through drawers and things. I guess looking for my enormous suit of powered armor. I don't know.
Edros is like, to the southwest.
You open like, up.
Where do you want to go? Where do you want to go? I'll be the legs.
And just opens up the teeniest like desk drawer. There's some Civ tchotchkes in there.
There's a key, but who knows where what door that opens up anymore.
Yeah, if I see any keys, I'm taking the keys.
There's an expired packet of space barbecue sauce.
Rail barbecue sauce, I think.
If you'd all like to continue searching here, make me another round of perception checks. Like I said, you haven't found anything yet.
Yes.
Tyler, don't even. Yeah, I'm, you're not allowed to roll.
Damn it.
Get out of here. Oh, goodness gracious. Tyler's done enough rolling for tonight. But we've got a 44 from a Andis 148 back.
I mean, if I keep rolling perception checks, eventually I'll land on that side of the die.
You're not gonna believe this. It's DC 43. There's some very similar looking, maybe familiar tubes hanging over a chamber towards a kind of vine shrouded little cabinet here that you maybe saw in a prior simulation back in the Kishali room. As you poke around in here, you find what looks like a piece of rail state technology. It's like a data pad almost. It seems to be designed with a great deal of quantum mechanics and energy. And as you like pick it up, it explodes in your hands as dozens of items quantumly entangled with it immediately return to normal space. And you get a big old bear hug from your your powered armor as it's like flopped down on top of you.
Oh,
yes. I guess I do technically need to know who thinks they have the lowest armor of any of these armor sets, because lowest level. There are rules for donning armor and donning it hastily, but we might not have to do them at all if you guys have high enough level armor. I think if you go, does anybody think they have 16 or below?
I probably do.
No.
I feel like I might. Let me double check.
Take a look. Popping out of this quantum.
Nope, I'm 17, so I'm good.
Popping out of this quantum.
Same.
Pad is also the armor and the heavy degenerator that you've pulled out of rail state.
Oh boy, oh boy.
Just all of your stuff just dropped onto the ground. Donning, I believe, heavy armor of level 16 and above takes 4 rounds. I imagine that's maybe first or second in everyone's order of operations.
Yeah,
first, your legs are here too.
Yeah, so Adros will put your legs on.
Yeah, how am I going to put on my armor with no legs?
Okay. Yeah, so you put your armor on, I'll put your legs on. And
can
then
we,
that way.
Can we do the legs first and then put
but we can do them simultaneously, right?
No. Put your shoes on first and then your socks. That makes sense, right?
Adros, you need to put on your armor first, dude. I think your armor is like, what, 19 right now? Something like that.
It's still 4 rounds. So you guys can, we've only taken a couple rounds.
It's level 20.
Yeah, we have the same armor as level 20.
It's level 20.
Yeah,
no, we're level heavy armor. I'm saying if you don't take the time to put on your armor before you start helping Alindra with her armor, then your AC is like
a thing.
20, right? Yeah, 19, 20.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Don your own armor and then help your friends. I think on an airplane, you always put your own air mask on first. So,
I'll put the armor on first. Then.
Yes, you. If you don't do that, then the child Alindra will be having a hard time here.
Don we now Alindra's armor.
Put her legs on one at a time. I don't want to do it, but just for fun, is Adros able to put the left leg on the left leg and the right accordingly, or are you now?
Can I assist in backwards? This somehow?
No, I got.
I just want to see how he does it first. Want to give me an engineering or?
Sure. 38.
Oh, yeah, you figure this out. You do. Maybe you have to put up like your hands to your head.
The big
first,
toes but. Are in the middle. Yep. Yep.
I will say all of your armor is here, all of your items except for a few. And you start to realize that as you get equipped and start equipping yourselves, we're missing some magical items and some very specific weapons. Raimi,
don't you dare.
Raimi, the Tiara of Translocation is gone. Alindra, you cannot find, or maybe Andis, one of the entanglement belts is gone.
Oh, no.
Oh.
Knack, there's no absolute zero. Hail cannon. And Adros, you know for a fact the Spear of Fates is no longer here.
Son of a biscuit.
That in the chat. I forgot all about that. Little,
oh, no, just not the little, Spear of Fates.
Little
oh, no.
I mean, just so it is known, in character, Adros is freaking out about that. Out of character, I'm relieved. I'm totally relieved.
That was like a level 13 weapon that you were just like lugging around like an albatross.
Yeah. In character, oh no. Out of character, whew.
Right. Yeah. So as you guys get your armor on, you hear coming from outside this room, just clank, 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 clank. Let's roll into the initiative turn order.
Patrick, I have an important question.
Oh, so, he'll be the judge of that.
though our squid selves were, damaged in certain circumstances, our, real world selves had been in there for like a week. What does that mean for our SP, HP, and RP?
Oh, all of that transferred over. I think we made that pretty clear in episode 2 of the simulation.
Here's something you forgot.
Any damage that you've taken is still on your character. Any RP that you've lost here. None of the items that you used were spent, though. So if you use them, I hope you kept track of them because they are still here.
Like I used anything.
I'm returning my haste circuit to 10 charges, right?
Yes, if you used. Okay. Use them. It counts.
I'm deleting my gun. Ugh.
Give us a roll miles into the Anish.
Oh, sorry.
Okay. Moving through the curtains of maybe a door you can't see here through an energy field, you hear clank, 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 clank. Indeed. Moving up on you is what looks like two large robotic civ monstrosities, but something seems familiar. It seems like you've seen one of these in disrepair before, way back on the World Seed. These two robots kind of rush into the chamber in civ, screaming, "Exterminate! Exterminate!" Let me show you what these guys look like here. Burp, burp. We're in initiative turn order, and Andis, you are first. Good, Sir Roger Burt.
Oh, right. All right. So the entanglement belts, those are the ones that gave us like the super flank and stuff that. We can still take half damage once per day. And
yes, you still have the badge.
Yeah, the badge is it take half damage once per 10 minute rest?
We'll look it up.
Yeah, I can't remember.
It's a reaction. I don't know if it's once per 10 minute rest.
Yeah. I think that the other ability is you can use the result of some of the other person's save. Like once per day.
The saving throw, yes.
Yeah.
You did use that in the simulation. It was not used up.
Yeah. Sweet. All right, cool. Yeah, we're going to walk forward. Let's see. Do I remember from seeing these guys before if they have reach?
I think pretty simply, yes. Mm-hmm. They are large and in charge, and they look like a robotic sieve.
They've got like the big
prehensile
tail there.
Massive stalk.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Trying to decide if I want to get myself reach and then attack him from afar. Yeah, you know what? Yeah, let's do that. Let's do that. I'm going to swift action. So swift action, give myself reach, and then use my quick draw to draw my weapon or to manifest my adaptive strike. Mm-hmm. And then I'm going to move up to 10 feet away. And I'm going to swing this mighty, mighty powerful fist. Fisticuffs Maximus. And just one hit here. Here goes nothing. 32 to hit.
That's a hit.
Oh, yeah. For 77 points of damage.
Ooh, lucky number 7. Okay. First strike one of these things, and yeah, it's a little easier than the last time you fought them. You're a little little stronger evolutionist.
Somewhat stronger, yeah.
Okay, I think Rainy is next.
All right.
Guys, it's very, very comforting saying your actual character's names.
Yeah.
Dropping the bit.
Yeah.
I have a question.
Error, yes, if found.
If we used an item, we got it back. What about spells?
Spells are still cast, still spent. Okay.
Raimi's like, oh, I got this cool shiny toy. I want to take it for a test drive.
Yes, your degenerator, heavy degenerator.
Yeah, so he's going to attack the same robot that Andis just attacked. And that's a 39 to hit.
39. That is a hit for sure. 18 on the dice.
And then it's... I need to actually make a thing for this.
90, 10. Is it plus 17?
If damage? If he uses your level... Oh, wait. He has 17 or... Yes.
Well, 18, aren't we?
18, yeah. Sorry.
Yes, 18. Sorry. It's like, what book are we in?
Yeah, I know. That's 67 points of damage.
Okay, oof. And that is all acid and sonic, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'll say with both of you guys, there seems to be a little bit of DR, but a lot of that's getting through. And it's not yet bloodied, but it's taken this one to the right. Two massive blows from Raimi and Undus. There's still one on the other side of the room, and it is Edros's turn.
Yay. I'm going to spend an action to enable a force field. I'm going to spend an action to run over there because I can't sprint. I can't charge through these simulation pools, pods. So I'm going to... I guess you can make an attack of opportunity if you so want.
All right, so you're getting right up next to this thing. It will indeed.
Right up next to him. I have a blade out. Yeah.
Okay, just a 7 on the dice. And remind us and the audience what your massive KAC is now. I'm pretty sure this is a miss, so...
43.
Yep. Alrighty, that will be your full turn, right?
That is my full turn.
Full turn, indeed. That brings us to Alindra Veles. Alindra Veles.
Alindra is going to jump really high in the air and fly over, photon attuned, but I'm going to fly over to the opposite side of this robot thing.
Okay. You're using the ability here. Does this...
Defy gravity.
Concealment or no? No, this is just the fly ability.
It's just the fly ability.
All right, let me make an attack of opportunity. I'm going to try my best. I'm going to try my best. Oh, it did pretty well. What is your KAC?
40.
A little lower. And that is, this is all bludgeoning damage. With a slam, one of these robotic tentacles does hit you with a 15 on the dice. So I'm going to get the D6 a flowing. That is only 55 points of bludgeoning damage on that hit as it slams into you, maybe right as you get by it and get around to the backside of an Andis 148. What would you like to do for your standard?
All right, I'm flanking. I should have turned my haste circuit on. Can I do that retroactively?
I believe you can do it not as a swift, but...
Yeah, I mean, like it's just magic action that I can do. Mm-hmm. All right, so I'm going to turn my haste circuit on so that I can take 3 attacks against this robot. It's a 32 on the first.
That's a hit.
All right, that does 79 damage.
79, oh boy. Why isn't my calculator slashing out?
33, that's going to be 84 slashing damage.
Well, that first hit is enough to break this robot in a glitching fashion. It's bloodied. I'm sorry, what was the second? Oh, the second is also a hit for how much?
84.
It's still up after that.
Okay.
Give us the gusto.
There's number 3.
What are you rolling on these dice?
30 died. All right, that does 85 slashing damage.
Rolling very well. Old double digits. Do you like to see it? I'm sorry, I talked over you there. How much damage?
85.
Oh, gosh, this one's still up for its turn. And indeed, it is going before a Nackfeld's bar. I'm so sorry, Drew. Never gonna get it. Was going to attack Andis 148, but I think Alindra has taken a little bit of
come at me, bro.
Away. Maybe. Let me just double check a rule real quick.
Does this mean that you? Oh, you don't get my flanking bonus anymore because we're missing the belt.
I mean, no, I'm still flanking with you, but
no. I mean the
super duper bonus.
Yeah, the super.
I don't get the +4. Yeah.
No. Sorry, I meant the haste bonus. Sorry, I misspoke.
Oh, right. Yeah, no, right. Oh, right. Haste. I don't. Haste doesn't apply to me. Yeah. That's right.
Okay. In the pain that I think this robot is, the beating that you've given this one on the right side, I think it's just going to... We'll try a couple of attacks against Alindra because I don't trust my dice rolling here tonight. So two limbs coming at you, try to pin you against this back wall. Ooh, I'm glad I did that because the first one is a miss, 6 on the dice, but the second is going to be a hit. Another 86 plus a bunch of damage. Okay, there's some good rolls.
Those are D8s. If you meant to roll D6s.
I gotta harsh my buzz, Jaberto. He's always correcting me. I was like, I rolled so much better than the whatchamacallit before. All right, that makes a lot of sense. I was like, oh wow, I did like 10 more damage. Yeah, I did a significant lower amount of damage. This is only 46 on this hit, Rebecca.
Okay.
Lindokely.
And that's still bludgeoning?
Just bludgeoning, yeah. Yep, no critical here. Let's see. And on Adrossa's side, I think we're going to do the same, just a single attack against you, sir. Just one. Until I can hit you. And a 16 on the dice is going to be hit, so this one gets a solid lick on Adross. And a little more damage, thankfully. 58 points of bludgeoning damage. And Knack, we're on to your turn. And you're the first person I get to talk to about some bonuses that you've drawn upon from your time within the Civ simulation.
Well, now this conversation is different.
Unfortunately, you do not have your ability just to cast disintegration. But from your time fighting against the head warden in the exemplary education simulation, you earned 3 lucidity points, and as such has been able to seek a truth about your enemy. And these are indeed Civ enemies. They're robots, but they are Civs. You understand, you know, the instructional paradigms of their dominion. And anytime on your turn, you can spend a resolve point and a full action. So it's a pretty big turn. Not saying you have to do it now, but one resolve point, full action. You can grant any ally within 30 feet of you the ability to take 2 standard actions on their next turn. It's very nice that the the envoy got that ability. We earned a couple other ones in the Civ simulations that we'll talk about in the future here. But what would you like to do for your turn, Drew?
See, the problem is I feel like we're pretty close to the end of this fight, so I don't want to. I'm sorry, Adras. I don't want to.
Well, yeah, and if it's just a standard action, sometimes that's not as useful. It can be a pretty deadly combo, I think, with Knack and a Raimi Quendar, though.
I wanted to roll more ones, and you'll take this away from me.
Yeah, I mean, or Adras, if he can charge as a standard.
That's true.
Yeah.
What would you like to do, Drew, for your turn, though?
I think I'm going to do something very, very typical. I'm going to point at the robot, the Civ bot that is menacing Adras. I'm going to say, get him. We are going to do a good old-fashioned bluff check to Clever Feint.
Oh, well, here's where I get to tell you your next bonus that Knack earned because of the socially appropriate party. Technically, both Knack and Alendra earned this one. You get a +2 circumstance bonus to bluff, intimidate, and sense motive checks against creatures with the Civ subtype. I know that might not be as useful for you if you've got its expertise circumstance as well.
I don't know that expertise gains circumstance, but I believe that it adds in addition to the expertise bonus. It's not like you don't get it twice.
Mm-hmm.
What are the skills that applies to?
Basically all the charisma-based skills. Okay. Bluff, intimidate, sense motive.
So that's a 42 before expertise.
Oh, yes, and I need to. I need to look at the DC for this.
Mm-hmm. Ah, so expertise is an insight bonus.
That is a success. Yeah, I was just looking at that as well. So just with that alone. So flat-footed, get-emmed. What else would you like to do?
Oh, we're going to shoot it with a gun that I accidentally deleted and then had to rebuild the entire time that we were doing this fight so far. So I hope I've rebuilt it correctly.
Oh. I should have told you, like, there might be more of those pistols, like, in this AP. Maybe don't delete them just yet.
Well, no, I roll 20. I just clicked the delete button and it didn't look like it did anything. So I clicked it again.
Oh,
and
no.
Then it deleted 2 things at once. So I'm very, very happy with roll 20.
Here we go. Mama mia, that's a spicy roll 20.
That's a 29.
9 on the dice, even flat-footed against EAC. Flat-footed, 29 against EAC. Actually, that's a hit.
Hey,
because of all your mini envoy bonuses.
19. Big 19.
Okay, first damage on this one here. That's going to take us turn two, and Andis, 148.
I'm going to, let's see. So I get 2 mutation points, so I'm up to 3, and right. I'm going to take a step in, I think. Mm-hmm. One of those 5-foot steps you hear so much about. And I'm going to swing real big, swing for the fences. Evolved strike. Oh boy, 30 to hit.
Against Casey, that's going to be a miss. Oh no. 3 on the dice. That is your full turn, correct?
Yeah.
Then we're on to Raimi Gwendar.
All right. You know what? First, same of the first. Or second verse, same of the first. I'm just going to shoot my new shiny weapon.
This one's looking very weak. That's between Alindra and Andis, who seem a little out of step. Normally they're doing like Evangelion battle dance together, but not so much.
38 right now. To hit.
Oh, that's enough to kill this thing. It had an embarrassingly low amount of points left. I think your level will do it there. That is one of these Civ Sage coffers, or what these are. Dead. Do you have a move action you'd like to do?
Yeah. Remy's gonna pop up kind of in between Andis and Alindra, so he has a good eye on the other robot.
Idros Varanus, we're on to you. You hear one of these things going down across the room from you. You've still got this one to deal with in front of you.
Triple attack.
Trippy attack? Oh, we got a hit. First one's a hit.
93 points of damage.
Ouch, what?
32.
Also a hit.
89 points of damage.
It's bloodied.
33.
Oh my goodness gracious.
That's 85 points of damage, Patrick.
Them double digits will do it. 85, you said?
Yeah. It's all slashing, so you probably are what's cutting got, that.
Yeah, damage reduction, but it is bloodied as well. And oh boy, we're on to Alindra.
All right. Alindra, once again, is going to fly across the room.
Okay. Moving up to this remaining robot's strike zone.
Yeah, I'm going to get on the opposite side of it from Idros.
All right. I'm going to try and hit you. Try and stab you. For doing this. And I've rolled an 18 on the dice. I can only roll. I can only hit Rebecca consistently.
I can take it.
We will.
For a little while.
I've confirmed these are D6s, not D8s. That is 59 points of bludgeoning damage.
Okay.
Your actions.
All right. I am going to strike 3 times.
Alrighty.
Since I'm flanking, I'm going to make this -3 instead of -5 to each base.
Well, it is.
It has get him and flat-footed to
get him flat-footed. Yes, so go ahead and roll that. We'll figure that out.
So -1.
Well, yeah,
it would be 5. You want me to do 5?
Roll your standard. We'll figure it out in post.
Okay.
Figure it out if needed.
So 33 to hit.
Yeah, that is a hit.
All right, that does 87 slashing damage.
I've cleared my calculator a bit too soon. 1 second. All right, it's still up, but this one's looking as weak as the prior one was before. Another sturdy hit will take us out.
31.
That is a hit with the flat-footed and get
90 damage.
That is enough to destroy this. Woo-hoo. The Civ robot. These guys went down a lot easier than when you were level 15, 16. I forget which.
I mean, we've also lived a Civ life. We are familiar with what it's like to be a Civ. We were able to target their weak points and vulnerabilities because of our experiences.
Before I forget, maybe a more important bonus that one of you guys got from the Battle of Laugh-Laugh. The simulation fighting against the Aklath. Andis 148 is the only one that got the 3 lucidity points in that simulation. And the last one is kind of a doozy. You get +1 AC against all Civ subtype creatures.
Oh, wow. Dang.
That certainly will not nice. Come into effect.
That won't come up, surely.
Yeah, unfortunately, these are the only 2, and they didn't get a chance to attack you. Yeah, so
the rest we're going to face is just zombie
yeah. Oops, all vampires.
Yeah.
that takes a weird turn. It's you guys fight against monster trucks the rest of this AP. I don't know what this GM was thinking. Wait, the GM's me. Right, as these robots slowly fade away, you know, the lights in their eyes going, they're saying, exterminate, exterminate. To be continued as well.
Also, I forgot.
We are back to reality. Whoops, there goes gravity. And you guys have found yourself aboard the actual Civ Super Starship.
A few months later, apparently, which is like probably not great for Absalom Station.
No, it looks like a few days. The inside of a week. Looking at Raimi's.
Yeah, I think worry, if Andis worry, has Jabert, an internal we, while clock, we did this, the ship just shut down to focus wholly on us and nothing else happened. Sure. Mm-hmm.
127 hours if Andis is looking at an internal clock or something along those lines. So
it's just been a few days.
Okay.
Yeah. Okie dokie.
Well, still no telling what the state of Absalom Station might be. But right,
we're gonna be like, we won, and we go out, right, and it's like there's nobody left. It's just fun. Who wants to explore the horizons of the vast?
I talked about this.
Let's roll it up.
Talked about this last week, but yeah, it was 4 years ago when you found yourself on the last giant Civ super weapon behind enemy lines, if you will. And ooh, we got a spicy rest of this book to go. I'm very excited, and we will get to it next time. Guys, thank you for playing with me.
Thank you.
Listeners, thanks for listening, all of our critter manders out there, and we will catch you next time back on Cosmic Crit.
Good night.
Bye.
Adios.
Listening to Cosmic Crit, an officially licensed partner of Paizo Incorporated. The Starfinder role-playing game and adventure paths are trademarks of Paizo. All Pathfinder and Starfinder images are property of Paizo and are used with permission.